High glory to God. Have you ever asked yourself, how am I supposed to make my day great? You know what? This Pastor Peter shouts about this morning, bringing God's word to you, and I'll be showing you how to make your day great. Glory to God. This morning, I'll be sharing from the book of 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. And it reads, it's a year of God, little children, and have overcome them. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. God's word is always fresh every morning. You know, God's word has a way of, you know, renewing and refreshing our thoughts and our minds, and inspiring us for greater things that the Lord has in stock for us. So as you've woken up this morning, it doesn't count a lot. It doesn't matter what you've been going through, or the situations that you faced, or that you slept with yesterday. Maybe the thoughts that feed your heart, maybe discouraging thoughts, thoughts that maybe really didn't comfort you so much, and you probably might have actually cried yourself to sleep yesterday night. But you know what? It's a brand new day. Yes, the Lord has given you the opportunity to start all over again and to get it right this time around. And getting it right means to, you know, to take a hold of God's word and to see the word of God produce the result that it talks about in your life. Hallelujah. And that's the beautiful thing that we have as God's people. The moment and time we got born again, the scripture tells us all things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new, which means we've got the life of God at work in us. Glory to God. And this scripture that we just read this morning, it's really, really informative, letting us know exactly our place in the heart of God. Actually, I'll be reading it with the Amplified Version. It says, little children, you are of God. You belong to him and have already defeated and overcome them, the agents of the Antichrist, because he who lives in you is greater, mightier than he who is in the world. Listen, there's a spirit that is in us as God's people, and it's the Holy Spirit. He's the greater one that is in us. The Bible says it's the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead, as we see in Romans 8 verse 11. Yes, that's the same spirit that raised him from the dead with so much power, that caused the stones to be rolled away, and Jesus came alive with power and strength. And the Bible said also there's also another spirit that's at work in the world, the spirit of the Antichrist that's at work in the world. But there's nothing to fear. There's nothing to bother yourself about. There's nothing to be moved about, because the one that is in us is greater. Is greater than the one that is in them. You know, there's the account of the prophet Elisha in the scriptures, when the king of Syria sent the armies of Syria to go pick him up, like a prisoner of some kind. And why they came surrounding his house, the Bible said when Elisha and his servant woke up in the morning, his servant looked through the window and saw their house surrounded by the army of Syria, and he shouted, he cried to the master. He said, master, alas, we are done for. There is the army that has come to pick us up. But you know what? The prophet was calm. The prophet relaxed. The prophet said, relax, for they that are with us are more than they that are against us. You know, there's something the prophet was seeing. The prophet was not just seeing with the eyes of the optical eyes, but he was seeing with the eyes of the spirit. And you know, he obviously saw that the servant was not still at rest. The servant was restive, and then he declared, he said, Lord, open his eyes. Lord, open his eyes. And the Bible said the Lord opened the eyes of Elisha's servant, and he saw, though he saw the armies of the Syrians, then he saw a bigger army. There was a heavenly army, the host of heavens, that was surrounding they that surrounded them. The host of heaven was encamping round about those who tried to come take them captive. So, you see, there was a greater army that was not obvious to the natural eyes. And you know what? This is very true in the life of every believer. This is very true in the life of every believer. Then, you know, the armies of heaven were with Elisha. They were with him. But in this case, for us as new creations, the armies are not only just with us, but they are in us. Hallelujah. The greater one, the scripture we just read, he said, but the greater one is in us. He said, greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. So the eyes of your understanding is open today. You operate in faith. As you go out, it doesn't matter what you see. It doesn't matter the circumstances that are about, that are round about you. Maybe the circumstances that have tried to take you captive in your head, on your finances, or in your home, or in your family, or concerning your relationship, or concerning your academics, or concerning your job or your business. It doesn't matter, those forces of hell that have lifted up themselves, and you know, like they try to take up Elisha and his servant, they maybe these forces of hell, agents of darkness and their works, they try taking taking you captive. But you know what? There is a greater one that is in you. There is a greater one that is with you. There is a greater one that is in you. He's greater than he that is in the world. The scripture says, little children, you are of God. It starts from there. We have to realize our place, our identity. I keep on saying it. Many children of God suffer for nothing because they don't know who they are. They don't know their identity. They don't know who they've been made in Christ Jesus. But it's time for us to wake up from our slumbers. It's time for us to understand who we really are. It's time for us to understand how God sees us. God does not see you as that victim. He does not see you that as that little you that is subject to the vagaries and the manipulation of darkness or witches and wizards or the manipulation of the devil. Not at all. God sees you as the victorious one because he has invested his life in you. He's giving you his own life. It's called Zoe. The very essence and substance of divinity is at work in you, and this life that is giving you is greater than the forces of hell put together. It's greater than Satan and his agents. It's greater than the COVID virus that is making rampage around the world and causing destruction of life and properties and economies. But you know what? There is something in you, the greater one, greater than the COVID, greater than the demons that are spreading on it, because the COVID is being spread by demonic spirit. This the Lord has let me know and shown to me. But you know what? We are greater because there is the greater one in us, greater than the demon that spreads the COVID-19, greater than all the forces of hell that try to afflict people. You know what? You're going to rise up in the power of the Spirit this morning as you go about your day, understanding the privilege that you have as a child of God, that you're not ordinary, that there's a greater one as walking you, understanding your place with God, understanding that you are a child of God. He's called you a child. He's a little children. You are of God and you have overcome. We are not trying to overcome, but we've overcome. Hallelujah. We're not making we are not on a wrestling match with the devil and his agent. No, but we are much more than conquerors. That's what scripture says. He said, for the greater one indwells you. Hallelujah. So you lift up those hands today before you step out on the street this morning. You say, greater is he that is in me. You charge up the life of God that is in you. Hallelujah. You begin to pray this way and the devil is in trouble. You begin to declare God's word to your life. You declare it over the life of your children. You declare it over the life of your family. You declare it over the life of your husband. You declare it over the life of your wife. You say, greater is he that is in me than the sickness that's in the world. Greater is he that is in me than the COVID-19 that's out there in the street. Greater is he that is in me than the cancer. Greater is he that is in me than the HIV. Greater is he that is in me than the blood disease. Yes, greater is at work in me. And just in case you've been diagnosed already with the COVID or with the cancer or with diabetes, whatever, heart disease, you know what? You said this disease is passing out. It can't stay in this body because the greater one is at work in me. The Bible says your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. And he said, whosoever defy the temple must be destroyed. So if COVID has come into the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is your body already, you say, COVID, you are the one who have intruded into the temple of the Holy Ghost. And therefore you are destroyed. You dematerialize. materialize. Hallelujah. You dematerialize. You speak to that COVID. You don't complain about it. You speak to it. Like Jesus spoke to the sea and they hushed. Yes, he spoke to the wind and it hushed. Yes, he spoke to the trees and the tree dried up. Yes, you're going to speak words this morning. Hallelujah. You speak to the tree. You speak to the wind. You speak to the COVID. You speak to the mountain. You speak to the sickness. You speak to the disease. You speak to the affliction. You speak to that devil that's trying to run rampage in your home. Yes, or in your family, or in your business. You say, you devil of darkness, you unclean spirit, you have no place here, for the greater one indwells me. Yes, you speak God's word. The greater one is at work in me. For greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Therefore, devil, you come out in the name of Jesus. You speak God's word. You speak as a child of God who knows his honors and who knows the authority and the place of privilege that he's been given or that she's been given in Christ Jesus. Yes, you are of God and the greater one indwells you. Hallelujah. You should let this truth sink into you. Let this truth be your reality today as you go out. You said the greater one indwells me. And you find out that you had an issue for the day, or there's a challenge that come up during your day, you say, greater is he. You remind yourself as often time as you have to, you do it. You remind yourself and you tell those situations, you speak to those challenges, you say, greater is he that is in me than the situation that is confronting me. Greater is he that is in me than the devil that's in the world. I'm a champion forever. Yes, for I've overcome them. Yes, you are not trying to, but you've overcome them. This is the way to talk, and this is the way to go. And as you declare these words in the spirit, as you prophesy, as you declare words in the Holy Ghost, you know what? You come out winning all of the time. Your life will be made much more glorious. Hallelujah. And for you, it's not yet born again. Maybe all that we say right now, it's like strange to you and you don't understand. Say, I don't know all this religious talk, I don't really understand. You know what? This is not about religion. This is about a relationship with God. This is about a relationship with the God of heaven and earth. His name is Jesus. Yeah, you can make him the Lord of your life today and have this beautiful koinonia, this relationship, this fellowship with him. Hallelujah. And you can enjoy the privilege that we're talking about. Hallelujah. And you say, Pastor, how is that possible? It's so simple. The scripture tells us in Acts of the Apostles 2 verse 21, he said, and whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And the scripture lets us know how to do it. He said, with a heart man believe, but with a mouth confession, declaration, announcement is made unto salvation. Now you want to do that today. Yeah. You want to make this prayer after me. You say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come to you just as I am, a sinner. But I've heard your word and I believe that you send your son, Jesus Christ, as the perfect sacrifice for my sin, that he died, that he was buried, and on the third day rose again for my justification. And today, I confess Jesus as the Lord of my life. From this day forward, I'm no longer under the kingdom of darkness, but I've been translated into the kingdom of God's dear son. And if you made that prayer from the depth of your heart, you're born again. Welcome to the family of God. Look out for a Bible believing church in the city where you live. Join that church so that you'll be groomed up and trained in the things of God. And if peradventure you live anywhere around Padova in Italy or in any of the adjoining cities like Vicenza, Ferrara, Rovigo, Mestre, Venice, even Bologna, I want to invite you specially to be our guest at Healing Grace Christian Assembly, Via J Avanzo number 17, just behind the Padova train station, as soon as you come out from the Acella direction. And we meet there every Sunday by 10 o'clock at Sunday schools, by 11 o'clock the main service. And on Tuesdays, we come together to agree with you for a miracle. And it's by 6:30 to 8 p.m. in the evening for our prayer meetings on Tuesdays. We'll be waiting for you with open hands. And you know what? If you've not subscribed on our YouTube channel, ensure to do so. The name is Pastor Peter Ashazobo on YouTube. Ensure to subscribe and turn on the notification bell, and so that whenever we post new audios and videos like we do every day, you'll be among the first persons to receive it. And you know what? You're going to do something good this morning. There's so much bad news in circulation. You want to be a carrier of good news. So ensure to share this message message with at least 10 of your loved ones, your friends and your contacts, especially your family members. You want to help them start up with a great day. So ensure to share the message now. This message, share it now. And as you do so, God bless you. Don't postpone it for later. Share it now. And as you do so, you are blessed. God bless you. And you know what? I'm going to wish you have a great day. God bless you.